Alrighty, I'm back. Everything's taken care of now. Yeah, so I'm gonna test the server. So I've got now stuff. And right. So what's going to happen now is that there'll be, I've got too many windows open is what I've got right now. Let's fix that. This one go away. This one. No, that's not the one. Oh, so of course. It is right here. So it suggested this right here, and I think that'll probably work. Let's curl work on. Okay. So if I start up the server. Bonk. Cool. And then let's try this. Okay, so that is good. So I can prompt it with just the word new and then my level. Great, and so now I can say, the corner, oops, okay, so it's screwing up now. Why is it taking so long to respond? Okay. That is almost sort of working. So now it's got the middle. And so I'm going to do 2. And I have totally perplexed it. Oh, goodness. I think I'm doing something good here, but I don't like the way I'm writing it. Yeah, it's really lo losing track of stuff here. That's funny. So this is actually going to be 5:11. Yeah. So now, Cool. So now this is going to be new. That should give me back there. Perfect. And so now give it 0, which is my first move. And it should give me back. Okay. Perfect. So these are going to be some difficult to read figures, but maybe who knows something to be able to. No, that's ridiculous. No. Well, that's actually probably a better way to do it. No, I don't think that's right either. So this is index is going to be a number, and so this is going to right here, update the board. And then I need to do yes, that's right. Yep, and then AI move is going to receive message history. Nope. We're gonna say cat response await fetch chat blah blah blah. Method post and stringify message, yes. And then ooh, yes. And turn data. Perfect. And this needs to be an async function. No. Yes. Okay. And so now, inside of the AI move, we're just going to call get AI move and pass in the message history. Right. History. We don't need this anymore. We don't need the random anymore. We do need this for updating the board. And so this is going to be AI move. No, equal get message history. That's fine. And then no, we don't need random. And then this will say move, except it does not return just a number. So I'm going to need to parse that and get just a number. And so I need a that's good. I'm gonna call this start new. Right. And then this needs to reset the board, and then it needs to do a call to the AI. No. I know what to do. me give it a yes. Not quite. Maybe it is. Okay. And so index.html. I now need to say here. Okay, that'll be fine. Button. Click does not equal reset. ID equals start. Start game. And so start new game. And I'm just gonna hard code level of difficulty for right now. Okay, this is totally not going to work. Because the server is only adding content right here. What it actually needs to do is go like this and tack message on there. This message is this object. And or messages an array. So message history. So message history gets passed to that get AI move. It sends in that message history. It's stringified. It needs to be unstringified. And then each item from that needs to be tacked on to here. This is getting way too complicated for one chapter. like that. I don't know. Well, since I'm checking for winning and losing on the client, it doesn't matter. Okay, so I'm going to say you respond. Only your mode. Yeah. So then the assistant should only respond with 4. And the user says 1, and then the assistant says 2. And this is going to dramatically reduce the amount of tokens I'm using. This is all going to require a whole lot of editing. And then the assistant responds, it's a draw. Zero, 1, 2, 3, 4, 6, 7, 8. So that's perfect. Okay, so now it's only responding with the number of its move. And that's good. And so now script. That should only be sending moves. Getting back moves. The one thing is that what I'm getting back from I'm getting very confused. So the server sends back this. Response. And the response is going to be the whole darn thing. What it needs to send back is just the message. So this should actually return data dot response dot choices. Zero content. Yeah. And so that's going to give me just the new message. And then, so I get the AI move. I get the AI move. This is going to have move console log. Move. So content is going to be, should be just the move, right? Yeah, in quotes. Okay, so right now I know that something else is going to be wrong. Well, maybe not. Should we try it? Server's running. And 5,000. We get a Coors error. Okay, ready to break. So server needs to use Coors. And then let's try this. Great. Connection refused. Server crashed. That ought to be fairly easy to do. Oh yeah, why did it do that? Crashed again. Say new message is not iterable. And so yeah, new message is what's coming in from the client when I click that. And it is going to be, should be an array, but I probably need to convert it. That. It's still saying it's not iterable. And that is because we need to figure out what new message is. There we go. So that's what new messages is. Okay, so what's iterable is actually the messages. Possible that that kind of worked. Sent it, there's no error. But I have a feeling that what we're passing to the AI is wrong now. So it's sending this messages, chunk, and then that should be tacked on to the thing. And so I think my API needs server needs to log exactly what is sent. Ah, stop all the pop-ups, you're making me crazy. Let's just say like that. And now let's cancel. Yeah, that's right. So that. And so what it's sending. Is your array. It should be correct. GPT-4. Should it be sending anything after that? Yes. So it closes the array and then it needs to do. Okay. And that worked, kind of. Next zero message, and then this should have the should be console log response. Choices, zero. I think I'm getting very close though. Oh, it should be. Message.content. That worked. So now I do that. I got an X, it returned a 4. But the 4 is not getting put on the board. Probably just because I'm parsing the response incorrectly. So I get this whole response. And then what am I doing with it? Script. Choices dot message. What did I say it was? Message dot content. Response choices message content. Data response choices message content. New game. responds with new game level 5. I choose, and then it responds with 4. And 4 is not getting added. So here. Is undefined setting near HTML. AI move, make move. So probably because that it's not actually saying it's a number. So make move is getting really cool. There's the make move. It's setting my move correctly. This is the one that's not. Working. And so console log move. So that should be happening. The browser. Oh, it's a promise. Ah. I need to await that. Oh my God. Oh, I think it's broken now. Expense. It responded with another 4. New game level 5. I'll bet if I did new game level 10, it would work fine. So let's try it now. Start game. Boom. Level 10. There. 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 Wait. Chose 4 again. I bet I'm using up an awful lot of credits. Yeah, no. I think I've really cut down on things. Okay. Let's start this over. New game, level 10. So now I just tried to play a square that I already played, or that it played already. So I need to tell it, probably just tell it don't. Pick something that's already been used. AI is stupid. Goes again. Keeps choosing the same number. Four. Oh, that guy is funny. I'm not adding the AI's moves to the message history. Yep, is that right? It is what it is. Work. I'm gonna have an AI tic-tac-toe game. So takes the message history, it awaits the new move, gets the move. And then it needs to append that. What a goof. Get AI move. Have to be. Assistant. And this is going to be I think that'll work. Let's try it. New game level 10. And then it responded with, I win. How does it think it won? I think I should just not have it even figure whether it won or not. Because I'll do that on my side. Confused it. Okay, so this is almost kind of working. Cool. Okay, it's time to take a break. And then I've got to come back and write about what I did here.